Hey, what's up? I'm Rekeema. Welcome to Detailed Dream, where the primary focus is to expose you to the expansive world of luxury goods for your home. And as many of you know, I'm a candle lover at heart. There is no denying that, but today I want to discuss something that doesn't have wax and doesn't require as much upkeep as a candle. As you can tell by the title of this video, I'm going to be discussing incense, but not just any incense, the art form of Japanese incense and why I think they should be something you should be burning. Incense are very exciting. When I was writing an outline to this video, I couldn't figure out what to talk about first because there's just so much to cover. And knowing me, I will forget a few things, but I can always make a follow-up video if needed. Or you can voice your opinions in the comments below. Okay, one of the main things I love about incense is that the cost of entry is very inexpensive compared to candles. There are many types of different incense, like sticks, coils, and cones. You can get really good Japanese incense from about $5 for a small box of short sticks. But they can get very expensive, reaching a few thousand dollars due to the type of ingredients used, and the depletion of resources plays a big part in the price as well. You better make sure you really love burning some incense before paying that much. But for the most part, if you're a casual incense burner, you don't need to spend much to get good sticks at all. Why would anyone use incense? Is there a specific reason why people choose them over candles? Well, there are many benefits to burning incense. Depending on the scent and what type of wood was used to make it, it could increase focus, reduce stress and anxiety, aid in sleep, and stimulate creativity. But you will mainly come across the use of incense in environments like meditation, religion, and the purification of cleansing air in a certain space. I won't go deep into this specific topic because it requires its own video. But I will say, if you're using Japanese incense for religious purposes, it's considered disrespectful to blow on the incense. It's better to give it a light waft after lighting it. When using Japanese incense, it's kind of an art form. Kind of like a ceremony, it's very therapeutic. At least for me it is. For me personally, I mainly use incense to purify the space when I feel the energy is a little off, or when I'm in an incense burning mood. So what is Japanese incense? What makes it so different from the other types? You have to know that Japanese incense has been used for over 1,000 years and has come to be known as one of the highest quality incense around the world. When making them, they are usually compressed or rolled with different types of wood, such as agarwood, sandalwood, and my personal favorite, aloes wood, which is top of the line in my opinion, and these woods are mixed with essential oils or resins. There are also well-known brands such as Shoido and Nippon Koro that offers low smoke options that doesn't fill the room with heavy smoke that you normally find with incense. And that's mainly because there isn't a bamboo core like you would usually find outside of Japanese incense. Then we get to Kayara, which means precious in ancient Japanese, and is also a wood type used in making Japanese incense. It's considered the highest grade of aloes wood that money can buy right now. It's actually more expensive than gold because it's considered the most precious resin in the world due to its high oil content and superior fragrance. Which is why incense used with Kayara will run you a lot more than other types of wood. If you're really into burning incense, I think it's well worth trying. There's absolutely nothing like it. I found Japanese incense to be much more pure in terms of fragrance in general. There's less smoke, and I love the fact that there isn't a bamboo core in most of them. Probably my favorite thing about Japanese incense that you can't normally get with candles is that you can dive deep into specific notes that you want to experience. Like if you want to find out what notes you enjoy most, you have that option compared to candles where there are multiple layers of notes within a single candle. What's on the box of incense is what you will get. For example, I found out recently that I don't really like the smell of patchouli from burning a patchouli incense. Now when I look for candles and it has the note of patchouli in it, I know I probably won't like it unless it's a subtle note. I didn't just jump ship after burning the patchouli incense though. I burned a candle that had it in the scent just to make sure, and I immediately smelled patchouli and confirmed I don't really enjoy it that much. I feel like I had a better understanding of that specific note. It's amazing to bring this knowledge back into the candle world and know exactly what to expect from different candle scents. I'm starting to feel like a sommelier for candles. Is there a job out there like that? Sign me up if there is. Okay, one of my favorite incense that I'm burning right now is Kiyonishiki, which is autumn leaves from Shoido. This is not an incense review, but I do have to say that autumn leaves is phenomenal and it's highly recommended. It gives off this almost sweet fragrance with a sandalwood undertone. I also have Nokiba, which is moss garden from Shoido and is another good one. My other favorite that I'm burning right now comes from Baido. Sorry if I'm pronouncing these names wrong, I'm trying my best. Baido is one of the old oldest incense houses. My favorite from them at the moment is Kayunko, which means good fortune. Man, I need to burn that one more. And that's made with a very, very good aloes wood. So when you get Japanese incense sticks, there are many objects that you can use to burn them in or on. The most common you'll find are incense holders that's typically wooden or ceramic. And it just simply holds the incense as it burns while catching the ash. They come in all types of different shapes, sizes, and colors that can coordinate with the decor of your home. But if you want to stick with the tradition of Japanese culture, then you can use what's called a koro. It's usually a small ceramic bowl that you will fill with either rice ash or white ash. White ash is the most common and easy to find. I much prefer a koro over the regular incense holders because the incense doesn't burn all the way to the end with a holder. There's always a small piece left at the end, which is just a waste of money. But with the koro, the entire stick will burn. Even when it touches the ash, the incense will continue to burn all the way through. But something to take note about the ash is that it's really light and fluffy, so if it's not compressed in the koro, the incense stick will tend to fall to the side, making a bit of a mess. So you want to make sure that the ash is compressed and the stick should stay in place. Even though Japanese incense are on the expensive side, there is no mistaking them for something else when they're lit. The quality is just unmatched, especially when there is incense from brands that's been doing this for centuries and some for almost a millennium. Now, I'm not knocking any other types of incense. I just much prefer Japanese incense because I found that there is nothing else like it. So when you go out to buy from a store, I would suggest not buying those cheaply made incense that you would get from somewhere like Walmart. I mean, if that's your thing, more power to you, but for me personally, I get all of my incense and supplies from japanincense.com. They have all that you will ever need from brands like Shoido, Baido, Kaigaro, to Nippon Koro, just to name a few. You can even get incense holders and kodos with white ash. If you do buy Japanese incense from a store, just make sure it says made in Japan. There's a lot of dupes out there and I don't want you burning anything that will cause you harm. You can also look on Amazon for different types of incense holders as well. There you have it. I think that covers the majority of the basics on Japanese incense. I know I'm forgetting some things, so let me know in the comments below. Let's talk about it. And let me know if you want to see more videos like this on incense. Maybe drop a suggestion on what you want me to review. I have a video scheduled to drop on Indian incense in the near future, so stay on the lookout for that as well. Thanks for your continued support of this channel. That's going to be it for today's video. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.